Hello everybody, welcome to Crafty Soup. My name is Misty. Before we dive into today's video, I want to give you a reminder that I did draw the winners for the prize packs that I had offered last week. So please do check your YouTube notifications to see if you were one of the winners. I have 3 unclaimed prizes left, so you have another week or so to get in touch with me to claim your prizes so I can get those shipped out to you. Moving on to today's video, we are talking about 10 ways to use Nuvo Drops. Once a month, I pull out an inexpensive product and come up with as many ways to use it as possible. So Nuvo Drops are only one brand of these liquid pearl type products on the market, and I will be using and demoing a couple of other brands as well. I'm going to do most of my demos on these little 3x4 cards. And then I have several varieties of Nuvo drops. There are glitter drops, there are crystal drops, there are dream drops. There's also jewel drops and stone drops. And each of these different kind of drops have their own bottle shape or label color difference. So know that about the Nuvo brand. So I will be demoing a variety of these here and tell you some specific uses for each kind. Now, of course, you can always just make enamel style dots with these either directly on your project, or as you'll see here in a minute, we can do them on a non-porous surface and then pop them loose from that and then use them later to add to projects. And so here, I'm just giving you a sample variety of all of the different kind of drops that I have. Now, I don't own everything, but I'll show you what I do have. And so here I put these drops on both a glass mat and just a scratch piece of plastic and let them dry overnight for 24 hours, and then I was able to pop them loose. You can also use a nonstick craft mat to do this. But I tend to like the plastic packaging the best because it lets us do some techniques that we'll talk about. I did also play around with the old Stickles variety of glitter glue type products, the old liquid pearls, which kind of preceded the Nuvo drops, I believe, and then a close to my heart glitter glue. The liquid pearls definitely did the best because they're made to create these drop type products, and the other two glues did not really hold up very well. They were just flat and blobby, and they did not compare at all to the glitter drops of the Nuvo, which did give a domed enamel dot effect. And here is a quick comparison look at all of the different drops. On the right-hand side, we have wet drops. On the left-hand side, we have drops that I did on a nonstick surface and let them dry and pop them loose and put them side by side with the wet ones so that you can see the difference. Let's go ahead and move on to some techniques to do with these. Now, of course, you can make dots with these, and that was the first thing I showed you, but you can also make other shapes. So you can, instead of doing dots, you can do hearts. I made a little Christmas ornament. You could also do an outline and then fill it in with a different color. And here I'm just doing concentric rings of various colors. So don't be afraid to mix and match products, mix and match colors, draw any shapes or sizes of dots or, you know, enamel style shapes that you would like to do. Moving on to number 2, we've got some frames and borders, and you can do this directly on a larger project. I'm just demoing this on journaling cards, and here is a style of frame that you could do. You could do that around a photo or around another significant element on a scrapbook layout or a card. And then here I'm just adding some doodles with my Nuvo drops to get a border effect, and again, mix it up. You could do squiggles, you could do polka dots, whatever you want to do, go for it. Let's move on to something a little fancier. We're going to do this technique that I called stained glass. And now you could use a black Nuvo drop to do this. I don't have black, so I'm going to use the darkest color I have, which is a navy blue. And here I'm just doing it on paper at first to do a sample, and I'm giving an outline, and then I'm going to fill in the gaps of my image with Nuvo drops that will dry more clear. Now, I did put a gold in there, which doesn't dry clear, but I only had kind of 3 varieties that will dry clear. The glitter does dry clear, but the glitter is colored, so that will block some translucency if you choose to use a glitter glue. Now, at first I was just doing freehand style with these. Now I'm going to trace over some images, and I just happen to stamp my images, but you can trace anything. You can trace patterns from a pattern paper. You could trace printouts that you create yourself. And I'm filling in, this is a magnifying glass, and I use a silver on the outside to mimic metal, and then I filled it in with a clear Nuvo drop to mimic the glass. Now here I'm doing a leaf pattern, and I don't have another green clear Nuvo drop, so I'm just using a close color, which is going to be yellow in this case. And you can see the difference between the ones that you do on the paper versus the ones that you do to be able to release from, you know, a plastic sheet or whatnot. They will have a slightly clearer effect to them, and then you can use these as embellishments on any kind of project. Here's a little bit of a close-up look at those. You can see how some imagination can take you anywhere. Now, if you have an image like a flower, these are great for that, so I'd suggest playing around and seeing what you can come up with. Next up, we're going to go ahead and do some writing. Now, you can do freehand writing any way that you want with these, either directly on your project or on the side to let them dry. Here, I'm doing it freehand with some help. So I drew some lines to give me straight edges to spell up to, and that helps my writing stay tidy. And then I traced it with pencil first, and then I erased the original pencil lines. But my actual writing, I can leave there if I'm using a product that will be opaque when it's dry and cover them up. If you don't like your own handwriting, we can go ahead and move on to this style where you can use a printout and then you can just trace over it. If you're left-handed, you can trace from right to left because you're not actually writing, you're just tracing, and that'll prevent you from smearing as you go. One quick tip on these is that you want to leave yourself plenty of space because the drops will spread just a little bit as they dry and harden. So small gaps like the spaces between the E can end up filling in if they spread too much, so you want to give yourself plenty of room in between those gaps, and also use a nice thick line so that these are sturdy if you're trying to use them as an independent embellishment. And then when you peel these off the sheet, they're a lot like those puffy words that are popular these days. They're a little more delicate, so you need to handle them carefully, but they are cheaper and you can make them say whatever you want. Next up, we're going to talk about making your own puffy style alphas. Now, this is much like the writing, and for this one, I do specifically trace over alphabets so that my style of letters are going to be pretty consistent. And again, you can use any of the Nuvo drops that you like, glittery, clear, metallic, whichever ones suit your needs are going to work for this. And then once they've dried overnight, you can go ahead and pop them off your sheet and then just use them like you would any other alpha. I will use a liquid glue to adhere any of these items down to my project. And that last letter E is a stone drop product, and it actually had the sturdiest consistency. It's actually kind of like toothpaste when it's wet, and then it becomes more rubbery when it's dry. So that one is an interesting product to use. Next up, we have fancy enamel dots and epoxy flares. Now, the technique is the same, but the finished effect is slightly different. I'm going to be using punches to create these fancy enamels, and what that means is you just have a pattern or an image underneath your enamel instead of a solid drop. So I'm using punches to punch out specific sections of pattern paper. For the flare, I'm using a larger 1-inch circle punch to punch out an image that will become a flare badge style embellishment. When you're punching out images, don't forget about branding strips on patterns because those tend to be scaled down prints that will work well for tiny punches. And also you can get into the nooks and crannies of larger prints to punch out the smaller bits like on that floral pattern. Once I've got all of my pieces punched out, I put down a row of temporary adhesive onto a protective mat, either plastic, glass, or craft mat like I'm doing here. Stick all those pieces down in place so that they will hold and not shift and move around on me because you don't want to touch these when they're wet. And then I just top them off with a clear Nuvo drop. And this is called Morning Dew, and it's a crystal drop that dries clear. Once they're all dry, I've got my finished pieces. Now, these will be softer and more flexible than an actual enamel dot will be, but they're fun and add the same kind of beauty and interest to projects. Now, the flare badge did kind of curl up on me a little bit just because it's paper with wet medium, but I was able to kind of fold it back into shape because the Nuvo drops are a bit flexible. Notice that the product looks cloudy when it's wet. However, it will dry clear and you will get a nice finished result. And then we can move on to faux acrylic pieces. So this was something I created a while back, that word you in white. And then I wanted to try doing it in different colors. And I found a cardstock that closely matched the color of my Nuvo drops because it's going to have thickness to it. You're going to see the edges of this. And then I die cut and punched three pieces of each shape, stacking up three layers of cardstock, gluing those together, and then topping them off with our shine. I topped the word with the same color as the cardstock, and then I topped the shape with the clear Nuvo drop because I hadn't tried the colors before, so I wanted to see how it would differ. And I think they both look great. I'm going to stick with the clear Nuvo drop because then I can do whatever color cardstock that I want and get the look with just topping it with clear. And then you've got pieces that look more like an acrylic piece versus an enamel dot piece because of the thickness of stacking up three layers of cardstock and then topping them off with our shine. Next up, we can use Nuvo drops with stencil as we would a lot of mixed media products. And here I've just got a couple of small Tim Holtz stencils. Now you can do this again, any size project that you want to work with. Be prepared to wash your stencils immediately after stenciling because if it dries on there, it can ruin your stencils. I have a little piece of cardstock folded up that I'm going to use as a squeegee. And then I just give myself a nice thick line of the drops and I squeegee it through the whole stencil. So for this next one, we're actually going to do two separate techniques with the stencils. First, we're going to mask off a part of the stencil using just a punch circle shape, and that will leave an empty space behind once we've stenciled. And then we're also going to blend and mix two different colors of our Nuvo drops. One is a glitter and one is not. And so you can mix and match these when using stencils too. Don't forget that you can clean off your stencil by printing onto another piece of paper and using that as a mixed media piece as well. And then when you remove that mask from your stenciled masked piece, that is yet another piece that you can use somewhere along the way. For some of these mixed media pieces, I will finish them off with some pin work or mix and match various pieces from the other things that I have created and build up layers of embellishing that way. So here is a quick look at all of those different stenciled pieces and how each one adds depth and dimension to your projects. All right, next up, we're going to talk about a resist technique. If you do heat embossing at all with stamping and heat embossing, you may know what a resist technique is already. So most Nuvo drop products have a plasticky sheen finish to them, which is going to resist any water-based ink products that you are going to put on these. So I just freehand drew some hearts on this paper, let them dry overnight, and then I'm going to use my blending brushes to apply ink to these projects. And I'm just doing orange, red, and yellow. And then I'm creating this sweet little colorful journaling card. And again, you can do this on greeting cards, scrapbook pages, traveler's notebook pages, whatever projects you can think of. And because those Nuvo drops dry to a plasticky finish, they are going to resist that ink. And then I will buff off that plasticky surface to remove any final ink. And then you can see some of that shine left from the Nuvo drops. All right, we got through the 10 that I said I would give you, but we've got a bonus one here. And this I just call the smear technique. And this one is really fun with the stone drops because it has a sandy finish to it, which is why it's called stone. And I'm mixing and matching the glitter as well as the crystal drops here to create kind of a beachy scene. And then once this dry, this is the interesting part about the stone drops. They don't have the same resisty plasticky finish to them. So if you add ink on top of them, you can get them to change color. So I have the kind of white stone drops and I will add ink on top of them. Here's a little bit of a close-up to see the difference between the uninked and the inked version. So that is at least 11 ways that you can put Nuvo drops to use in your projects. Let's talk about some tips and tricks to help you avoid some challenges. Occasionally, I will get a clog in the tip of my drops, particularly the glitter drops. So I just use a pin to pop that clog loose, and then I'm sure to kind of use the tip of the pin to kind of scoop it back out of the tip so that it won't continue to clog. Sometimes you can get bubbles in your product as you're squeezing it out. I take care of this in two different ways. I will often tap or bounce the bottom of the project to help those bubbles automatically float to the surface and pop. If they don't pop on their own, I will get out a straight pin to poke at them until I can get them to pop. And then I will smooth over the drop to hide the hole that was left. Now here's what happens if you don't let your products dry completely before you start handling them. Specifically, if you're trying to peel them loose from a nonstick surface so that you can use them as an independent embellishment. The first time I pulled this one off the sheet, it was doing fine, but as I moved it around, it started sticking to things and breaking. So you need to let these dry for at minimum 24 hours, and really I would recommend 48 hours, just so that all of that tackiness has a chance to set and dry before you handle these pieces independently. All right, let's talk about storing these items. If you do create little independent pieces, you can store them in little bins. I like to take a piece of cardstock and put a temporary adhesive across it and just tack them into place on that card, and then I can tuck those into some kind of extra plastic sleeve or Ziploc baggie, something like that, to keep them all safe. I also do keep my excess packaging trash from other products. And I will cut them open on one edge so that they can open and close, and then I will put the dried Nuvo products inside of here. Again, I will usually use a temporary adhesive to tack them in place so they don't fall out of this sleeve. Thanks for sticking with me to the end of this video. I know it's longer than usual, but I would love to know if you have any fun ways to use Nuvo drops. Leave me a comment below. I do have some other videos using Nuvo drops, as well as at least one other technique, so I will link you up to those, and I will be back next week with some layout process videos for you.